Slipper the D, just slipper the D. Poor man's drunk news. Why your usual golf dick slash NASCAR dick slash fuck, what else am I? Your UFC dick, and lately now I'm premiering on my channel. I don't know what I'm gonna do with this yet. Maybe it might be a drunk news segment, but I got a new automotive sort of deal, driving tips, car tips, yada, yada, yada. Call that cold tires. We'll see what happens with that in the future. What else do I got going on? What else? What else? Oh, the Drunken on Drugs Wrestling Hour. I think I'm up to the volume 3 on that episode. Well, Josh couldn't be here today. I'm gonna leave the poor guy alone, because he's gonna be a very brave man when he goes in for his surgery tomorrow. Going in as Josh, coming out as Jolene tomorrow, folks. So you know what? You're brave, Josh. I'm happy for you, buddy. We knew, especially after the last episode of Drunk News, that yeah, you're getting borderline drag queen, and now you really just got to go push it to the full transvestite. Anyhow, so I'm filling in today with the Poor Man's Drunk News, Volume 4, I believe. Again, apparently the creator of the show, the main eventer of the show, is curtain jerking today. So I'll be the early edition. Corey later on will be the late edition tonight. But again, not to take any away from Corey, he's a good man. I respect a lot of what he does. It's one of the main reasons why I want him part of Poor Man's Drunk News. But I just don't get how the fuck me, the golf dick, is not the fucking main event. Like, I'm what makes everything. Like, I'm fucking just awesome. Every time I wake up, I piss excellence, bud. Like, I'm not even just, like, I don't even know how Josh doesn't realize how fucking great I am. Like, I'm just as great as Colin Kaepernick. Anyhow, so I'm glad you're part of the project either way, but man, it's like I should be main eventing. I shouldn't be curtain jerking. I shouldn't be opening nothing. I should be the reason why people fucking come. But you know, I guess a discussion for another day, you know. I guess more than all the reason that people say I'm an arrogant, snobby, what else? Douchebag, narcissistic, an asshole, condescending prick, whatever you want to throw out there, there on and so forth. So, anyway, here's the news. In Iowa, this recycling can business, Carrie Sapp, teased her husband before that Brad about being afraid of ghosts. Well, apparently they're hearing whispers inside their coming inside their house. It was freaking the shit out of them because they were making jokes about ghosts and all this. And next thing you know, they're hearing these weird voices and stuff like that. Turned out this wasn't a ghost. This was a naked man in a chimney named Jordan Kajewski. It's like K-A-Jew and ski, how it's spelled. Getting weird with Shane right fucking there, folks. Fucking, what can't I do? Anyhow, they found the man actually naked inside the chimney. No clue on how, he fucking became naked, whether it's like he was realized he's stuck in the chimney, so he's just trying to fucking find any way to fucking shim himself out. So hey, having clothes on, you know what, I could get you fucking, that's just extra shit to get you fucking stuck, so whatever. So firefighters in Iowa had to come and rescue the man. They fucking, first they were gonna originally try to pull him out with a rope. That didn't work too well, so then they had to fucking hammer parts out, or hammer a hole, and then pull them out that way. Apparently, this Jordan Kajewski has been to that business slash residence on three separate occasions. As he tried to apparently apply for a job there three separate times, so I don't know whether maybe he was trying to put in a new application. Maybe he was trying to sneak right into that chimney and drop a new resume right off the owner's desk. I don't know. If you look up at the fucking dude's picture, he looks like a fucking extra from The Walking Dead. Fucking just black soot, fucking shit all over his fucking face. He's got long, dirty blonde hair, fucking wearing a toque. I'd almost say it was Josh for a second, but then I realized, nah, this guy's got a little more blonder hair, and this guy looks like more along the lines that this guy looks like he's got AIDS. Not saying that Josh might not possibly have AIDS, but this guy definitely looks like he's got full-blown AIDS for sure. Now this guy's got to go and seek the, this guy's going to be standing in front of a judge sometime soon. That's all I can say is that's just pretty fucked up. Just that whole scenario, why a man would try to climb, like, again, being this is a recycling plant, was this guy trying to sneak in, steal empties, or, yeah, I don't know. And why would you try to fucking attempt to steal from a place that you fucking tried to apply for three times? It's like, your face is well known, you've been seen around there, so if all of a sudden you did break in one night and stole a bunch of shit, your fucking description would now be in the neighborhood in case somebody did see you fucking flee the scene from that building. So you obviously are a dipshit. And you deserve to be in fucking jail for being so fucking stupid. Funny what possibly could be fucking drunk alcohol related story. Brighton, it's between Toronto and Kingston. I don't know where the fuck it's in. That's like one of the parts of Ontario I never visit. Fucking, maybe fucking Jason knows since he's Mr. Ontarian over there. Fucking, so I don't know. I used to live in Ontario, but I don't think I've ever visited that part. But apparently police were called in for what neighbors were thinking was a domestic dispute, as they knew that this couple lived in this house. Well, when police arrived at about 8 p.m. To go and check into the investigate what the neighbors were talking about, they found a man, which is, I guess, since the guy really never committed a crime or didn't do nothing wrong, it's not facing court. No names are mentioned in the paper, but they found a man that was having an altercation with his pet parrot. See, the reason why neighbors feared It was a domestic dispute because there is a woman that is apparently lives in the residence with the guy, but she was not there at the time. So this argument was this guy liquored right the fuck up and fucking just arguing with a parent. Apparently some of the quotes that could be heard by the neighbors yelling, which I could, you know what? I would fear for safety too if it was like a couple. Like, I would fear for the woman's safety myself. When you're hearing things like, I hope you die. I'll put an end to you. Like, yeah, if I was hearing those type of things too, I would be thinking there was a fucking murder going on myself. So, no charges are being filed. Whatchamacallit? I can't pronounce this fucking stupid Ontario name, but Northumberland, OPP Constable Steve Bates said, I already said what he said. Fuck. This is what happens when you fucking are an alcoholic and you try to do the news. I don't know how Josh does it. In fucking sports today, news I want to touch on. Oh, I'm going to be a fucking one of the most hated men in the world for even fucking talking about this, but I don't fucking care. San Francisco 49ers coach Chip Kelly has officially now declared Colin Kaepernick going to be the starting quarterback this fucking weekend. After miserable fucking showings by Blaine Gabbert, the fucking goof, piece of shit, motherfucker, I just want to kick that guy in the fucking skull right now, especially his last fucking performance. Yeah, nice pick in the fourth quarter, you fuck. Anyhow, so, Chip Kelly, despite all the controversy of Colin Kaepernick being a little cunt right now, taking a knee during the national anthems and fucking having his hair looking like he's fucking Big Bird's fucking double. He's gonna fight. Well, also they had to do some tweaks to the contract too, his current contract. But yeah, he's gonna be starting this year. Thank fucking God. As much as he's acting like a fucking cocksucking douchebag motherfucker right now, 49ers fucking desperately need something. Fucking Gab, the last two games I've watched with Gabbert in, he looks scared, he looks desperate, he looks flaily, fucking, he looks like something in, like, those football movies, the guy you yank out, and all of a sudden the guy out of nowhere comes in and saves the fucking day. That's the type of fucking quarterback that Blaine Gabbert looks like. So I'm get riddance that goop, fried the fucking pine, get your ass on the fucking bench, where you fucking belong. But Colin, big words for you as one of your fans, as much as you've been acting like a fucking cocksucking fucking idiot lately. Don't screw this up, buddy. You don't really have any more fucking shots, to be honest. So, maybe somehow you could fucking, like, what I think Niners are 1-3, I believe, right now. Maybe 1-4, I can't remember at the moment. But maybe somehow you could clean slate and just go on a run and fucking win the rest of the games. Because otherwise, I don't think we're going to be fucking making the playoffs the way it looks with fucking Seattle and fucking... Fuck you, Seattle. Yeah, Deconi, you heard me say that. Fuck the Seahawks. A 12th man could suck my cock. The way Seattle and fucking Arizona right now are looking, fucking... I can't even see fucking Niners even snagging a wild card. The last story I wanted to get into... Sounds like something I would possibly do, except I don't drink and drive. Story I want to bring up. Fucking thing. Police had a Quebec man pulled over. I was 29 years old. Near the town of Scott, it's called. About 45 kilometers from Quebec City. Well, Originally, the man was pulled over because he cut off the police vehicle. So the officer, Sergeant Claude Denis, pulled the man over in his patrol vehicle after being cut off. The 29-year-old fucking believed to be intoxicated at the time. So what the man did as he's being pulled over, as he's being questioned outside his vehicle by the cops, he straight up fucking hauled ass to a nearby river and jumped the fuck in and started trying to fucking swim away. The cop, obviously, because you know what, it's getting pretty cold. Like, in the West Coast, it's fucking cold right now, so I can only imagine that cocksucking fucking stupid frogland fucking area. It's fucking really, really fucking cold. Constable Denise, or other police officers down the road ended up seeing the guy fucking walking away from the, walking away with a fucking pair of wet clothes. And he had somehow in this journey after fucking swimming in the lake to get away from cops, got his hands on a pair of firefighter's pants, which he was wearing with his wet clothes. As the cops seen this guy fucking walking around. The suspect's name's unknown at the time. But he's expected to face numerous charges of obstructing the police, refusing to undergo an approved screening device, break and enter, and theft and mischief. So this dude, just from fucking trying to avoid a DUI, just like rightfully probably fucked himself for life. Not only is he probably never gonna fucking drive again, he's probably never gonna ever get a real job. Then again, this doesn't sound like a fucking dude that probably has a fucking real job to begin with. So anyhow, I just wanted to get off. Big thanks to BigJoesBikerRings.com. Still trying to figure out how to hand out the shit. The belt buckle, I'm still, to this day, I'm making a wrestling match happen for the fucking Wrestling Hour or Drunk News. For both, actually. It's going to be a little clips of here, a little clips of there. Maybe do something like, kind of like that goofed pug one along that lines. I should never said that on camera. Big thanks to Josh for letting me even on Drunk News to begin with and fucking having me fucking run this time slot, especially it's a major time slot. And right now with Swear Night having next to fucking nothing as content. And who else do I gotta fucking thank right now? Big thanks to Corey for doing the, whatchamacallit, doing the after edition, the later edition of the Poor Man's Drunk News. So hopefully, man, you kill it tonight like you've done the last two times you've been for Poor Man's Drunk News. And shout out to State of Disgrace, your guys' fucking, I think their YouTube channel is Raven Roulette. Their fucking shit, man, is awesome. Like, I don't know how they should have way better views. They have one of the best, like web series I've seen yet. I don't, like, honestly, these guys deserve to be on TV. Another thing, I'll give a shout out to Disc Golf JR. So, apparently you want to step in the big league, son. Buddy, I can't wait. We're going to have some fun. All right, boys and girls, take her easy. Corey, now on to you, my friend.